In this problem, we're going to look at one part of a refrigeration cycle. So we have adiabatic compressor that raises the pressure of an ideal gas, and the gas is at 0°C and it goes from 2 to 15 bar. The adiabatic compressor efficiency is 75%, meaning it's 75% as efficient as a reversible compressor. And the question is, what's the outlet temperature? So if we look at a diagram, this is our compressor entering at 0° and 2 bar. We're leaving at 15 bar and a temperature that we want to determine. We're given the heat capacity of the gas, 35 joules per mole per Kelvin. And we're giving the efficiency 0.75. So the approach is first to do the reversible calculation. So we're going to do the reversible calculation, get the reversible temperature, then use efficiency to get the irreversible work. So once we have reversible temperature, get the reversible work, we use efficiency to get the irreversible work. This allows us to get the irreversible temperature, the actual temperature that we're trying to determine. So a multi-step problem. First step is, let's do the calculation for an adiabatic reversible compression. And this means we can use the equations that we derive for adiabatic compression that relate temperature and pressure. And those equations that we can look up in thermodynamics textbook. So absolute temperature, T2 over T1. So this is T2, this is state 1, this is state 2. This is the reversible case. So T2 reversible is related to the pressures, gas constant, and the heat capacity. The pressure, final pressure, 15, initial pressure, 2. The gas constant, R, is 8.314 in units of joules per mole Kelvin. So 8.314 over 35. We can do this calculation to get T2 over T1. Is equal to 1.61, and this means that T2 is 1.61 times initial temperature, inlet temperature is 0 plus 273, so absolute temperature, so T2 is 440 Kelvin. Remember, this is the reversible temperature. This is our first step. Second step, the reversible work, which is equal to, for a flow system that's adiabatic, is equal to delta H. Delta H for an ideal gas is Cp delta T. We're assuming a constant heat capacity. Final temperature 440, initial temperature 273. So the work for the reversible compressor is 5865 joules per mole. So our third step now is to calculate the irreversible work. That's the reversible work over the efficiency. 5865 over 0.75. It's the reversible work divided by the efficiency, because we know when we're adding work to irreversible process, it's going to take more work. So the irreversible work must be greater than the reversible work. And the number is 7820 joules per mole. Well, now our fourth step is to use the same first law relation, but now for the irreversible case, and of course, delta T for the irreversible case. So that means 7820, which is the work, is the heat capacity, the T2 irreversible minus T1, which is 273. So T2 irreversible is 496 Kelvin, and this means T2 irreversible in centigrade is 496 minus 273, or 223 centigrade. So notice, first reversible case, the temperature, final temperature is 440 Kelvin. Now T irreversible is greater than T reversible because we put more work in the irreversible case. So that checks as we expect. And so our final actual temperature, T2, is probably in significant figures about 220°C.